center quarterback exchange for the pass to either the fullback or the tailback. Now, coaches, understand this. The center, when he snaps the ball and executes the exchange, he's not going to explode out like he does in the running game. He's going to stand up and actually be pushed by the nose tackle. You need to spend some time on this. This will change the mechanics of the exchange. When the quarterback is trying to drop out, he might have the feet of the center stepping on him. We don't want that to happen, but as a coach, you should expect that it's going to happen. We're into the passing game now, and now we're going to get both backs out for a route. Fullback's going to work flat routes. He's going to come through the line of scrimmage. Always show us that you had the football. That'll make the linebacker stay. It'll eventually open you up. So come through. You're not going to get a hand fake from the quarterback, but drop your arm over the invisible football as you attack that cone, which is 3 yards over the line of scrimmage, and then break through the flat. Tailback, you're going to run a swing route opposite the dive. So we say dive pass right. You know you're running a swing route to the left off the toss look. Good crossover step. Belly back a little bit more and fake like you got the toss. Now you have an opportunity to attack the line of scrimmage coming forward. If we do throw you the ball, you'll be facing the defense, which you need to do to do a good job. Next thing, quarterback, as you drop back, I'm going to be the free safety. I'm going to react for you. In whatever direction I go, you throw to the opposite back. I'm doing that more that you don't drop and predict in your mind prior to the play who you're really going to throw to. Okay? I will dictate that to you. After we go once, we're going to rotate. The center becomes the tailback and everybody else moves up. Okay? Let's go. All right? I'm the free safety. On you, quarterback. Catching the football. The number one thing you want to do is be in a position to turn upfield immediately with the football and not waste any space with the football in your hand going sideways. We're not gaining any yards that way. Here we go. Left.
Ready. Set. Go.
Then the big fullback scores again.
When throwing the ball to a back, especially a short distance, it has to be a catchable ball. Your young quarterback may drill the ball, and it travels such a short distance, the receiver doesn't have a chance to adapt to it. A softly, deftly thrown ball. A foot in front of the numbers without the receiver changing stride. That's an art form. That's a skill. That's not just natural. So your strong-arm quarterback doesn't have any advantage here. It takes accuracy, and above all, coach, it takes repetition doing this over and over.
Now that you understand the rotation of the four players through the drill, it's time to set up two or three drills and again at least eight, and if you have 12 players in your group, 12 going at a time. Don't recommend more than 12 because some of these routes, like the toss pass route, creates width. You want everyone to work to the same side at the same time so we have no groups working in conflict and actually causing collision.